pretty seasick.
but mixed feelings about this kayaking.
I feel like I've found something I don't want to do later on in life.
It's not really sea kayaking, we're more river kayaking and lake kayaking. Through shit.
Maria.
Pretty shit. Get it? Because I just walked through a fucking ton of shit.
Feel soggy.
Well, not quite what I expected. A little more cow poo to continue with the experience. But it does mean that the kayaks slide quite nicely. So the footwear, probably a little bit more tread might have been the go. All of these are fine.
At the moment when we just walked through a heap.
And as you can see, we've got all the boats across the road, no one's been run over. Just found out that the dips are only doing 15 k's a day, whereas we're doing 24.
And then down here to the left, there's like a couple of patches where you can sort of fit like a kayak through the trees, and we'll just chuck in down there.
We've got to look faster, you know. You guys committing?
Yeah, we're committing.
So, I just made up a game, it's called There's Golden That There. So basically you have to find the weirdest thing where golden would be. So you go, there's golden that there river, there's gold. So you have to go from like, something that's not very, you know, something that could have gold. So there's golden that there mountain, there's golden that there hill, there's golden that there river, there's golden that there tree.
Puss. And then you've got to drop in, and it's got to be like some sort of sea animal. And it's got to fit into the beak, so it's like... shark.
Cool.
You've got to put it in the mix.
Okay.
And so it's multiple syllables, if it's like, go quick. It's got to fit in.
Okay.
Shark! Eel! Starfish!
So you say two actors and then everyone has to try and guess the film?
Yeah, we're playing this game.
There's golden that their kayak, there's golden that their jacket, there's golden that their hat, there's golden that their nose.
Did you get all that, Brody?
Huh?
Nah.
The woman said we can camp wherever we like. She said choose somewhere dry, something about a paddock somewhere miles away, but this looks pretty good right here.
Bridge to, I guess, the start of the lake, and then like home run back.
When we get to those places, there'll probably be our food breaks too, so just be prepared for that. If you're not happy with your boat or anything, don't be afraid to speak up, because we can do some rearranging, so it's fair on everyone. Anything else anyone wants to add?
Did anyone see the tallest mountain outside of the Southern Alps this morning?
No. You can always see it.
It's disappeared now behind cloud. Yeah. You can sort of maybe see it.
You can always see it in the afternoon and the morning. Yeah. You'll see.
Mount Tapua Ōnuki, which roughly translates to the footsteps of the rainbow god. It's called Ōnuki.
2,880 metres.
There you go. Taller than anything in the North Island. Also kind of, we didn't kind of touch on this when we talked about history of this place, but I had looked into some of the more recent history from what Angie and Serena Beth looked into. This Lake Ōnuki was a really important place for the local Māori, because probably for lots of spiritual reasons, but it also provided lots of food in the form of seabirds and eels. And when Pākehā came here and they started, you know, farming the area, they had problems with the flooding that was caused by just the nature of the land and the rivers and the lakes. And they actually deliberately opened the mouth of Lake Ōnuki. So that's kind of a man-made thing. I know it does close off sort of from time to time, but it was typically always closed. Every now and then it would, in a flood, it would open up. But it meant that this was like usually full of eels, and they'd pull sort of like 20 tons of eels out of here every year. And so when the Europeans came in, they kind of illegally blew that open, and apparently local Māori were pretty off it and tried to stop them physically, like a non-violent protest. Took the tools off the diggers and tried to fill it back in by hand, and then they tried in the courts to stop it, but it was overturned. And then they gifted the whole area. This is owned by Māori. They gifted it to the Crown, thinking that it would protect it, you know, that it wouldn't be then taken over by private settlers. But yeah, you can imagine what happened then. And they were given a reserve that's way up in South Waikato and 2 grand. So they got this little bit of marginal land way up in, yeah, South Waikato somewhere. And this is all basically private land now.
Face above the water, my feet can't touch the ground, and it feels like I can see the sands on the horizon. Every time you are not around, I'm slowly drifting.